Hey everybody, Jeff Williams here with AskJeffWilliams.com. Okay, now remember on my last video on Pocket of Gold, I told you that if you get enough gold out of that little seam of iron oxide, we're going to melt it down into a button or an ingot or something of that nature, hopefully a bar, right? So, what we did is we got enough of it and we're going to melt it down into a button. And we're going to be using the flux that we bought at the gold show. If you remember that video, 2012 gold show video. We got a poor man's crucible here, so we can melt it up in there. We got our little stirring spoon for the flux. Got a scale so we know how much gold we got. Gold! And of course we got the gold. We're going to be using matte gas today. It gets the gold up to about 1950 degrees if you hold a concentrated flame on it. Of course we got our safety gear here so we don't get burned because we're going to be walking around molten metal. And of course, we got some graphite molds here that we got at the gold show. Now, I don't know if you can see that, but that's a 3-ouncer. Ooh, I'd love to fill that one up. That's our goal right there, is to fill this little one up. And then of course, I bought this one for my wife. It's a little cross, and one day I'm gonna make her a pendant from all the gold that we're getting out of that seam. So, anyway, what we're gonna do is we're gonna mix all this stuff together, and then we're gonna make a big button out of it and find out how much it weighs. So, wish us luck. Okay, so, what we're gonna do first is we're gonna start off with our flux and our gold. So what I'm gonna do is I've already seasoned this a couple days ago. As you can see, it still has some of the glass in it from our another melt that we did. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a little bit of, about a half and half ratio. Sounds good? It's almost like bacon, huh? So I'm gonna put a little flux in there, not a lot. And I'm gonna dump all of our gold in there. There she goes. Ooh, isn't that pretty? See it all in there? Yeah. Gotta love gold. And maybe take a pinch more flux. Not a lot. Just a little bit. Cover up some of that gold. Get all those impurities out of there. I know, I'm not using the proper stir stick, but I'm using a ballpoint pen. I'm gonna stir that gold around in there. See that? I'm gonna get all that flux in there. And our gold. Stir it around. Ooh, look at that pretty gold in there, huh? I wish that was in my gold pan. And we'll put just a little bit more. Like I said, it's about a half and half ratio of flux to gold on top of that, those fines. Like such. All right. Now we're ready for the heat. And hopefully we can get ourselves a good button out of this. Wish us luck. Okay, so. We got the gloves on, we got the face shield on, we got the matte gas. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna slowly, gently heat this thing up. Not too fast, and there's a reason behind that, but I'm just gonna slowly burn around the outer edges. I don't wanna crank the flame up on this thing. And I know a lot of guys use acetylene, but you gotta be careful because if you exceed the temperature too much, you'll actually vaporize that gold. You don't wanna lose your gold up into the air. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slowly heat it up. And you'll start to see bubbles forming up out of there, and then I'll slowly turn the heat up further and further, and then of course you'll get a little cooling going on, and then you'll see the gold melting in the middle. So here we go. Okay, so I'm slowly turning the heat up, ever gently, because I don't want to blow anything out of that bowl.
on top of the flux, and it'll slowly molt and become liquid.
That's a button. If I can get this out of there without marking it up too bad. Okay, so we went ahead and melted our gold down from that dig into a shiny little button. Now look at that. If that ain't the prettiest thing you ever did see, I don't know what is. Ain't that a beaut? All right, come here, take a look at this. Let's see how much she weighs. Okay, I got my handy dandy scale right here, zeroed out, plop that thing down there. Wow, 11.6 grams, holy cow, that's better than I thought we did. Wow, that's almost half an ounce. Not too bad for about a couple days work, huh? So anyway, we got our gold down. I know there's still some gold left in here because I can see it all around the edges and down in the flux. I'm gonna mess with him later. We didn't pour him in a graphite mold today because these buttons look better when you leave them inside and they cool this way, unless you got a whole bunch of gold to put it in there. So anyway, that's today's episode of Melting Gold Down Using Flux. I hope you've enjoyed it. And until next time, this has been Jeff Williams with AskJeffWilliams.com saying, I hope there's gold in everybody's pan. See ya.